So guys, everyone, welcome for the Pitch Perfect session and Outgoing Global Volunteering. So I'm Nitni, so currently the CVP for JVB2C, so I will be handling this session. So first of all, I'll just set up your expectations. So as usual, how the previous sessions has happened, this training will be in English. And also, since this is this will be the final session for the B2C people, so you guys have to pay maximum attention to this and make sure to get all your questions clarified throughout this session. And you also please ask questions if you have got any doubts, but I like appreciate if you guys can save it till the end so that I can run the session smoothly, and also give feedback if there are anything that I can develop, so if we can eradicate throughout the action editing on throughout the sessions thing, please let us know. And don't worry, you guys don't need to take notes or anything, because the whole presentation will be shared after the meeting. Okay, good. So pitching is basically guys a selling technique, okay, through which we try to persuade our customer to buy our relevant product or service. So with regards to ISAC, it's basically global volunteering. Okay, moving on, who is our customer that we have got for GoodDB? Can someone speak up and tell me? Give me. Who is the customer that we have got for global volunteering?
Exchange participants?
Yes, right. So we have got exchange participant as our customer. Cool. Okay, so moving on, when we are pitching for our exchange participants, there are mainly three methods of pitching that we use. Basically, those pitching methods are based on the channels that we use to pitch. Channels means basically the social media or the telecommunication methods that we use to pitch for our EP. So basically, we pitch our customers through physical meetups, through text messages, and through calls. So you guys, you have to make sure that this pitching differs from one channel to another channel. So when it comes to physical meetups, what you have to do is you have to make yourself good at elevator pitching. So what elevator pitching is that? Elevator pitching is the pitching that you are doing inside an elevator to a customer. So you, as you guys know, I hope that all of you have gone through an elevator. So basically when going through certain floors, you are getting only few minutes. And not even few minutes, few seconds. So during that time period, you have to sell your product to that certain customer. So physical meetups is kind of like having some sort of that scenario, because when you are having the physical meetup, you basically go through that when you are doing promotions. So as you all have been to promotions, I think that you have got an idea that you won't be getting a lot of time to interact with the EP. So during that short time, you have to tell all the relevant and important things to our customer. So for that, you guys have to excel in the elevator pitching. So that is what is important when it comes to physical meetups. And when it comes to a text message also, you can't like put lengthy paragraphs to the EP. You have to make the text message highlight the important stuff while making it short and sweet. Okay. But when it comes to the calls, you can like do the call like 30 to 40 minutes, but basically beforehand you have to get the permission from the EP, because everyone is like leading a busy life. So beforehand you have to acknowledge the EP that hi, so this call will last for like 20 to 30 minutes. You have to get the relevant permission and only you have to start talking. So I hope that you guys have got a certain idea about the method of pitching and how the pitching will be different. How you communicate the message through one channel to another. Okay, good. So before pitching, there are like certain things that you have to get yourself covered. Okay, we'll move on. So the first thing is you have to know the product. Okay, when you know the product, the first thing that comes is prepare in advance. So when preparing in advance, guys, you guys have to know each and every single details about global volunteering and the opportunities that the EPs are getting. Okay, so this preparation has to be done by yourself when you guys are going for a promotion. So before going for a promotion, you guys have to know each and every single nook and corner about JV, because when the EP asks you a question, you should not be stuck there. You have to be able to reply them. So for that, you have to prepare in advance. So for that, you can get the support of the TLs or either me. And you have to prepare with the points that the EPs will be questioning about you. Okay, moving on, the next thing is cover all the necessary points. So when you are like getting to know the product, you have to like, when you're preparing yourself, you have to cover all the necessary questions that will be asked by the EPs. So for that, you have to like do checklist, as in like what is missing and what I have done, what I know about GV, all sort of, and come for a certain analysis about yourself. So then no points will be missed by you. Okay. And the next point, be confident about the knowledge. So I am asking you guys to do this because the main question that the EPs are going to ask is like, have you gone for an exchange? So you guys have to make sure that EP doesn't ask that question about you. So, and also you have to be confident about the product, because like if they get to know that the buyers are not acknowledged about the product, then they will be reluctant to use it. So, not the buyers, sorry, the sellers. Then sellers means basically you guys. So if the sellers doesn't know about the product, then the buyers will be some sort of like showing a reluctance when it comes to getting the product. So you guys have to make sure that you know all the necessary details that you need to know about JV before like starting to do the pitching or like before going for a promotion. Okay, cool with that? Okay. So the next thing is, guys, know the customer. So when knowing the customer, first thing you have to do is you have to do a background check. Okay, so this background check is done, and it can be done when an EP has been assigned to you through expert. Okay, so I'm asking to do this, guys, because then it gets easy for you guys to interact with the EP. Because like if you don't know anything about the EP, then you will be lost of words to talk with the EP. Because like once you know a person, only the communication goes first. So you have to do a background check. You know all the details. So from the expo, you will be able to get the phone number. And if the person has updated his profile, you can get to know about his school or his current university. Or if you need to get more details, you can look into his CV. And also, I know that you guys are like living in social medias like 24/7. So if you guys are really keen, you can do a little stalking also. So by do a little stalking of the customer through like any of the social media, just try to get an understanding on what kind of a person is there. And like if you are able to get an understanding easily, then you will be able to pitch the product directly to the customer. Okay, so the next thing is first message and call. So guys, the first message and call is the first space that is like brought to you to make the bond with the customer, that is basically our EP. So you guys have to make sure that you are getting the maximum advantage of this. So by the first message and the call, you guys have to know at least, a current update of the EP, as in what he's currently doing and like how's his status and all. So then when doing the like the warm call for like 30 to 40 minutes, the EP won't be like uncomfortable with you. They will be so comfortable with you, and it will be like you'll be able to take along the conversation and the call for a longer time. Because like if the EP is not comfortable with you guys, he'll try to disconnect the call as soon as possible. So you guys have to make sure that by the first message and the call, you kind of make a bond with the EP. Okay, and the next point is body language. So guys, this body language is very important when you are participating for a promotional stall. So when you guys go for a promotional stall, there will be various people coming for it. And also when that happens, you guys have to know how to understand a person through body language. So it's really easy to understand a person if you are able to analyze their body language. Then you know how to talk to this person and how to address their emotions. So when knowing the customer, this is one of the main important points. You have to have the ability to identify their body language and analyze it. Okay. And the next thing is know the situation. So with regards to the current situation, you guys always have to address the prevailing issues in the society. So when it comes to that, now currently we have got the COVID-19 situation. So now the best thing you can't do is you can't pitch the product. As in, you can't ask the EPs to like go for a GV, go for a global volunteering project, so and so. You can't do that. What you have to do is you guys have to make ISAC relevant to what we do. And through that, you guys have to do like, because you guys know that like ISAC is striving to achieve peace and fulfillment of humankind potential. And to that, you have to align our product and you guys have to talk sense to the EP. Okay, that's what I have mentioned as address the prevailing issues. Because like you guys have to tell to the EP that through global volunteering, what we do is we select some sort of a problem that is mainly the SDG goals are based on the world issues now. So you guys have to say that what we do is we kind of like address the world issues, and through that, and as ISACers, what we do is we try to like make an impact to the world, as well as by giving a personal development to that person. What we do is we try to eradicate that problems through by a certain percentage. Okay, so you guys have to address the issues that we are having right now. And the next thing is customize your pitch. So you will be coming across various people. So some people will be outgoing, some people will be shy, or there will be some people who are like interested to go for a traveling project. So you guys have to customize your pitch accordingly. So for a person who likes traveling, you can't tell that person that, okay, there are many opportunities where you can go and volunteer. That the main thing you have to do is go volunteer and work for there like 8 to 9 hours. No, definitely that person will reject that offer because that person is a traveling person. And for like that sort of a person, but you have to promote an opportunity that has got less work but more traveling. Okay, so you guys have to know to customize your pitch accordingly to the EP. So for that, you have to get an idea from the EP, as in what do they like and their interest types. Okay, and the next thing is know the crowd. Okay, so this is also important when it comes to a promotional stall. So like suppose that you are having a stall at the Slim. So I hope that you guys know what SLIM is. SLIM is basically Sri Lankan Institute of Marketing. So there you guys have to know the crowd. So basically you know that at SLIM there are undergraduates who are following courses from marketing, HR and business management. Okay, so for those people, like if you like promote something like with regards to health aspects and zero hunger and gender like equality or something, like if you pitch our opportunities like that, then those guys won't be interested. So for those people, since they are more like aligned for jobs and all, you guys have to pitch opportunities that are like more aligned to their internships, so which are like based on designing, marketing and some opportunity that gives the scope of the organization. Okay, so that's what you have to remember when you know the situation. And also there are certain points that you have to keep in mind when doing the pitch interviews. Okay, so is everyone cool up to here? Have you guys got any questions? Can't you hear me properly or anything? Is everyone cool with me up to now? Okay, I hope that everyone is clear. Okay, nice. Guys, if you have got any questions, please drop in the chat box and I'll definitely reply once we are done with the presentation. Okay, so moving on. When doing the pitching, these are the points that you guys have to keep in mind. So first thing is you have to highlight the benefits. Guys, when highlight the benefits, you guys have to talk with experience. So as I mentioned in one of the previous slides, when we are like pitching to the EP, one of the main questions that the EPs are going to ask from us is, have you gone for an exchange? So you guys have to talk so well to the EP that they won't ask this question from you guys. So I know that like only few have gone for an exchange, but you guys have to talk that you guys have like gone for an exchange, because that's how we'll be able to like make some sort of a confidence level within the EP about our product. Because if they get to know that we have used this, like we have gone for an exchange, then they will be more confident and they will rely more on us. So when highlighting the benefits, what you have to do is you guys have to talk with superb experience. And the next thing is say only what's relevant. Okay, so when it comes to an EP who's some sort of an outgoing, it's really irrelevant if we say that, okay, like you will be developing a totally different person once you go for an exchange and come back. Like you will be so outgoing and all, you will develop your leadership abilities, because an outgoing person already had those things. So you, and also for like kind of a shy person, like we can't say, like it's not good to say like you'll have to like undergo many challenging experiences, then that person will get scared. Okay guys, so you guys have to make sure that you say only what's relevant to the EP. So, and also relate to your EP. So it's like basically same as the second point, but like when it comes to relating to your EP, you have to talk sense to the EP according to their personalities. So the benefits should be highlighted based on the EP traits as well as the personality. Okay. So these are some of the main benefits that you can get from global volunteering. So when like if you are given an overall scope to the EP, you guys can highlight mainly these three things as experience new cultures, make new impact, and push yourself out of the comfort zone. And then the sub points are the things that you can tell like eventually to your customer if you guys have got time. And also you guys can tell about the like the benefit that we are giving, like from ISAC in University of Colombo, as in we give them the visa support, so and the EP buddy from the host country, so and so you can highlight those benefits even. Yes. And the next thing is no sales should be done during pitching. I'm saying this guys because at the pitching, what we do is we basically try to raise the interest of our product, that means global volunteering within an EP. So what we do is we mainly acknowledge about our product to the EP so that he makes an interest towards our product, like he will be looking forward to use it. So at this point, we should not rush into making a sale, as in like to making a sale means basically when it comes to B2C, we should not rush into making that person apply. Okay, and be on point. You guys have to like be on point, and you guys have to make sure that all the issues which have been addressed by the EP are being clarified by you guys. Okay, and address all the issues. Yes, so you guys have to make sure that like before an EP asks any questions, what I suggest is you the whole issues raised by the EP should be clarified through the message or the call that you guys are doing. Okay, so you guys have to look into that and make sure that no issues have been raised by the EP afterwards. Okay, so these are the things that you have to like keep in mind when an ideal pitching is happening. So first thing is you guys should not sell logic, you guys have to sell emotions. That means you guys have to talk sense to the EP based on emotions. So basically there should be an emotional conversation between you and your EP. So that means it should not be professional. It's okay to be casual, but you have to remember that ISAC is an international organization. So for the ideal person, you got, for the like for the relevant person, you have to highlight the professionalism. But in the meanwhile, since GV is not so related to professionalistic background, you guys have to, it's okay for maintain a casual conversation with the EP. Okay. And also the next thing is find emotional triggers and use them wisely. So you guys have to, that's why I told you to like understand the body language. It's like really important for the members to understand the, for the ability to understand the body language. So by then, like it's easy for you guys to use them for your advantage. Okay. And the next thing is use powerful words and build trust. As mentioned in the previous thing, that's what you guys have to do. You guys have to create the bond between the EP and you, because then only the EPs will be able to rely on you. So basically to trust you guys. Otherwise, if the person doesn't trust you, they won't believe anything that you are saying afterwards. So first thing that you have to do is you guys have to build that certain bond between your EP. Okay, and you have to lead the conversation to your desired outcome. So that's what I said, you have to talk relevant. Once you talk relevant to that person, you'll be able to make that person interested to what we want to make them interested very easily, because we are addressing their issues while we are selling our product. Okay, so these are the things that you guys have to keep in mind. And after pitching also, there's one main important thing that you have to do, that is following up. So when following up, you guys have to be friendly with the EP. Like an EP will be only likely to reply if you guys are friendly with him. If you give them the first impression that you guys are not friendly and not so easygoing and no, then they will be reluctant to maintain the conversation with you. Okay, so you guys have to show that you are having a friendly ambience and also you are very easygoing with them. And also give them a deadline. So once you are done with the pitch and all, and once you're done explaining all the points that they need to get clarified about JV, you guys have to give them a deadline to come up with an answer. Otherwise, what happens is you are also waiting, the EP also doesn't reply, then eventually you will be forgetting about the EP. So you guys have to give them a deadline and make sure that they are attending to it. Okay. And the final one is open up yourself for any help needed. So basically, once you're assigned as an experienced manager, what we are doing is you will be the person who will be supporting the EP throughout the experience. So this is for B2C as well as PS people as well. So you guys have to open up yourself for any help needed. I know it might be very tiring sometimes, because sometimes the EPs are expecting spoon feeding, but anyways, you guys, it's better if you can try to understand with regards to your perspective, how would you react if you are in the same situation as the EP? So then you will be able to be more human towards the EP and give the maximum support to them. I know it might be sometimes troublesome, but make sure that you give your best to the EP and provide the best support, because that's what we have to do as an experienced manager. Okay, cool. So this marks the end of the presentation. So there will be some small call to action, since this will be the final presentation under B2C. So first thing is you have to look into the issues that you have got from all the presentations that I have done and get it clarified. Okay, so I will be giving certain time periods for you guys for both the teams. So that's with regards to B2C. And also, if any of the others from other functions also have got questions or clarifications, please don't hesitate to contact me. I will be willingly able to help you. So guys, you guys have to look all the presentations that I have done from the beginning. And if you have got any issues, you have to direct them for me. Okay. And the next thing is, this is for the teammates. So you guys have to get to know the biggest regret of one of your teammates. Okay, so I will be asking about this once we are having a team meeting. So you guys have to make sure that you have attended to this. So TS, look into this and check whether your members have attended. Okay, kids, this marks the end of the presentation. So I hope that everyone got their doubts clarified, and I hope that you guys have got a clear idea by now on how to do the right pitching. So yes, thank you guys for joining the session, and I really appreciate that, and have a nice day and good night. Stay safe.